Hello, my name is Mrs Molesworth. I live in the railway cottages at Horsecane Station on the Bluebell Railway. And it's a lovely place to live if you like trains, and I do. I know all the station staff at Horsecane Station, and I know all the engine drivers and the firemen, and I like going out to wave to them when the trains go by. I also find it very convenient to get on the train at Horsecane's and go shopping in East Grinstead. And that reminds me of a story I'm going to tell you about what happened the last time I went shopping in East Grinstead on Gala Day. Gala Day is when the Bluebell Railway gets out all the engines and the trains, and sometimes has engines from other railways come and visit. So it's a very busy day with freight trains and passenger trains and mixed freight and passenger trains going past my house all day long. And I thought this would be a very good day to go shopping because I wouldn't have to wait very long for the next train when I was in East Grinstead. So I collected my things, got my basket and my handbag and my knitting. And I went down to the station and I got on the train at Horsecane's. And I sat next to a very nice man. He had lots of cameras with him and a notebook and lots of timetables. And he had a flask of lemon drink. And he offered me some, but it looked a bit weak to me, so I politely said no thank you. I actually really like a nice cup of tea. We got to East Grinstead and we said goodbye. And I went off into the town to do my shopping. I had one or two things to get. I wanted to get some dog shampoo and a new saucepan and one or two other things. So I went round, got my shopping, walked back to the station. I got everything I needed. Got my dog shampoo. Mr. Molesworth's favourite biscuits. Some bananas. Cauliflower and a brand new saucepan. So I got to East Grinstead station, got my handbag, got my train ticket and got on the train. And I sat next to the same man that I'd sat next to on the way up, which was nice because we could have a nice chat. I got on with my knitting. We rolled down the hill from East Grinstead and we went straight through Kingscote Station, which surprised me a bit because the train always stops there. But I didn't worry too much, I just got on with my knitting. And we came to the tunnel, and although the lights in the train came on going through the tunnel, I did have to stop knitting for a few minutes because it weren't that bright, not bright enough to knit. So when we came out of the tunnel, I put my knitting away because I knew that when we'd gone down the hill, we'd be getting to Horsecane Station. And as we went down the hill, I got my things ready, got my basket and my handbag. I got ready to get up and get off the train. But the man sitting next to me said, "Oh no, you can't get off here, it's non-stop. Look at the timetable." And he showed me the timetable, non-stop all the way from East Grinstead to Sheffield Park. "That's good, isn't it?" he said. "Well, not," I said, "if you live at Horsecane's and want to get off there," which I did. But I couldn't. I had to stay on the train all the way to Sheffield Park. When I got to Sheffield Park, I got off and I went to see the station master. "Oh, hello, Mrs. Molesworth," he said. "Been shopping, have you?" "Yes, I have," I said, "and I need to get home. What time is the next train?" He said, "Well, let's look at the timetable. The next train to Horsecane's isn't for an hour." "Well," he said, there's a freight train, but you can't go on that." "Well," I said, "that's not good enough. I need to get home. I need to feed the chickens, and Mr. Molesworth's gone out for the day. can't wait a whole hour. Well, said the station master, let me see what I can do. And he walked off in the direction of the signal box to talk to somebody. I don't know, I thought. Can't wait a whole hour. I wonder what he's going to sort out. Well, he soon came back and he said to me, it's all right, Mrs. Molesworth. I've sorted it out. I've had a word with the crew. Crew, I said. What crew? The crew of the S-15, he told me. They're going to Horsey Canes. Light engine. That means just the engine and no train. And they said you can go with them on the engine. The fireman has very kindly said you can sit in his seat while he shovels the coal and ride up to Horsey Canes. So, that's exactly what I did. I got my basket and my handbag and my knitting and I sat in the fireman's seat of the S-15 all the way from Sheffield Park to Horsey Canes. I had a great time. I watched the fireman shovelling the coal, and I watched the driver driving the engine, and I watched all the scenery going past, and it seemed no time at all before we'd arrived at Horsey Canes, and the driver and fireman were helping me down and saying goodbye. And as I walked up to the cottages, gave them a wave, said thank you. Now, a couple of weeks later, my next door neighbour came up to me and showed me the latest issue of Steam Railway magazine. And he said, there's a picture in there, a lovely picture of the S-15 going from Sheffield Park to Horsey Canes light engine on Gala Day. Do you know what he said? There's someone sitting in the fireman's seat wearing a red hat with cherries. Looks a bit like you, Mrs. Molesworth. But of course I know it can't possibly be you. Well, I said, actually, it was me. And the fireman took a photo of me that day, and I can prove it. And there it is. Me on the S-15. If you've enjoyed this story, and you'd like to read more about me and all the engines at the Bluebell Railway, stories about them, you can join the Stepney Club and get the Stepney Club magazine 3 times a year. Stepney will also send you a birthday card on your birthday, and you can get cheaper travel for you and your family. If you'd like to join the Stepney Club, go to bluebell-railway.com and you can find out there how to join. And now I think it's time I had a nice cup of tea. Cheers.